Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll be covering how to fix the most common errors in Excel. It can be frustrating when either moving data or creating formulas and they come back with an error. So now you'll know what you're looking for within these errors and be able to fix them. The first error will be the divided by zero. All these errors have a hashtag in front along with a caution sign that if you hover over will tell you what's going on with this error and give some insight on how to fix it. So this formula function is dividing by zero. So if we go and just move the denominator in this case from 0 to 10, since any number divided by zero is undefined, when we hit enter, it will come back with a result. The next error will be the value error, which is just simply saying that the two data types used within the formula don't combine. Take, for example, taking E2 plus F2, taking a number and trying to add zero. So if you're going through formulas that have this error, you'll either want to change what you're adding by. So we could either do, instead of adding by the text, we can add by another number, or we could, instead of add, we could either concatenate, or we could do zero and ampersand plus zero, the text, and then drag this down, which would concatenate the zero and the text to zero for all of these. The next error will be the NA, which is saying that a value used is unable to be found by the formula or function. So let's take, for example, this lookup function. We're taking the lookup value 23, trying to look in the column E, and it cannot find the number 23. It will then return column F, so we just want to make sure that this 23 is something that's included in column E. So we can change this value to 20 instead of 23. It'll come back with the correct result. The next error will be the name error, which is saying that either the formula or function or the text within is unrecognizable. So we hover over this, we can see what it's trying to say. And if we take a look at what's included, that we spelled sum with two M's. So whenever we delete one of these and hit enter, the correct result will come back. And then we can see that there's a missing semicolon here, so it doesn't know how to read the formula. If we correct that and hit enter, the correct result will come back as well. The next error will be the hashtag ref, or the reference error. This will happen a lot of times when you're pasting data from one sheet or one workbook to the other. For this example, we have a unique function. So we're taking the unique values from E2 to E7. And let's say we tried to copy this formula into a new sheet. When we paste it, it comes back with a reference error, saying that it doesn't know what cells to reference and therefore can't return anything. So this will be important when transferring formulas from one sheet to another and trying to look up the same type of data. And to fix this, one thing you could do, if you just want these values onto another sheet, you could copy them all and then paste just values, if that's what you're trying to get pasted onto a separate sheet. Or if you want to take just the formula, you would need to change what it's referencing. So you could delete all of these and then choose a new selection for the formula. The next error will be the spill error, which is simply saying that there's not enough room of cells to fill out the rest of the formula. So for this example, we have all the values F2 to F4. And so this spill error is saying we try to take the row E2 to F2 and display them, but we have this blocking it. So if we just moved either this or this formula over a cell, it now has room. So that's all the spill error is saying, is that the formula needs more room, more cells, either in a row or column to fill out the rest of the results. And the next error isn't actually an error. It'll just be having hashtags and not displaying the full number. So what we're going to want to do is just hover over the column where we see the double-sided arrows and double click. So that will autofill the width and then you'll have the full number displayed. But another common error could be when pasting from either a web page or a different type of file, either text or CSV files, not having the full number display. And for this example, I have a notebook with some large numbers on it that we are going to copy and paste into Excel. As you can see, we try to get the column width, but it doesn't fix anything. So what we're going to want to do is change this to a text and then repaste. And now we'll have the full number available without it auto-correcting and be able to be changed or copied from these cells. The next error is not very common, but will be the null error. This is simply saying that within a function or formula, we're missing an operator. So this could be a plus or minus, but instead is blank. So where there should be something in between this, such as a plus, there is just a space. So simply changing that space to an operator will fix the error. And the next error is the calc error. So this is saying that empty arrays are not supported, but this can often happen with a filter function, where we're trying to filter E2 to F7, depending on the value of E is equal to 6. It cannot find 6 in this, so it's saying it's an empty array. If we change this to, let's say, the number 5 here, it will then filter for that. So this will commonly happen in a filtering function, and you'll just need to make sure that what you're trying to include is not a value that won't be found in the included array. And the last error will be a circular reference error. All this is saying is that we have a formula that, take example E2 plus E3 plus F2, which is the cell the formula is in. So it's called a circular reference because the formula with which the cell is contained in is referencing itself within the formula. And one way you could check this is by going to the formulas tab, going to error checking, and checking circular references. As we can see, F2 does have a circular reference error in it. And all we need to do to fix this is make sure that we're not referencing the cell the formula is in contained within that formula. And that's all I have for you in this video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like and remember to subscribe. And thanks for watching.